Tula Evidence Tole. I'm just going to share a piece of my life story with you tonight. Yes, I was born and bred in Tolosa. My parents then bought a house at Extension 2, and then that's where I live now. Alright, I grew up in a loving family. I can say that we had everything that we needed. My father provided, and I grew up with both parents, my mother and my father, and my siblings. It was lovely and all that. Okay, the tragedy started when my father passed away. It was 2007, August. I still remember it as if it was yesterday. Well, yeah, he passed on Monday, and then we had to bury him. Okay, I was very close to my dad, very close to my dad. Like, people called me Papa's baby, because, yeah. And yeah, I look like him. Yeah, my life started getting not so good, but I took courage and I got strength knowing that my mother was still there. But yeah, 3 years later, same day, same month, same everything, my mother passed on as well. And then we had to bury her as well. 3 years later. Now, that was a shock. To me, I had no one at that moment, because I was now closer to her. Because when my father passed on, I got to be closer to her. I was close to her. I shared everything with her. Everything. She was like my friend, my big sister, and all that. Yes, I had my sisters. But yeah, they didn't, as far as I understand, they didn't understand or get who really am I, or maybe how to treat me or relate to me, you know. So when my mother passed on, it was extremely difficult. Now, what made my mother's passing more difficult, it was the fact that I didn't actually get a chance to mourn her. So many things happened. Family, you know, my sisters and whatnot. There was a lot of misunderstanding and a lot of fights. It was difficult. It was difficult to a point that I had to move out of the home that I got comfort from, you know, knowing that it was my parents' place and I could be at home and feel comfortable and be myself, actually. But yeah, it was difficult to a point that I had to move out. I actually spoke to my elder sister, moved out. I stayed at her place in a bedroom. I had to really start life afresh, you know. I was older, but yeah, knowing that I was unemployed and my parents did almost everything for me made it extra difficult, because now I had to start afresh. And mind you, I had a son by then. He was 7 years old. So I stayed at the shack that I bought. It was nice and whatnot. So I had to make that a place, or rather a home, for me and my son, you know. And it was challenging. It was very challenging. But my older sister then became like my mother, you know. She was one person that I could confide in her or cry in her shoulder. But the fact that when we grew up, we had a distance, Nyana, when we grew up, therefore, it was not like really, really comforting. But you know, for the fact that she loved and feared God, I think that's what made us to become maybe closer, because she understood life better. That's what I thought. And she really introduced the praying part of our lives back, you know. And it was terrible, you know. At other days we would go to bed, you know, with like semi-empty stomach. I can say that because we would just drink water or maybe drink porridge, because now it was too much for her as well. You know, the only breadwinner in her household, now she had to take two people as well. But yeah, she didn't complain. She didn't really treat us differently. We sort of like developed a relationship with her as well, me and my son. When I say we, I include my son as well. So because now we're trying to build a relationship with her, the other sister, I think, failed somehow. Anyways, it's a story for another time, but she was the reason why I actually went to stay with my older sister. You know, family politics. But I wouldn't lie, they made me believe that they made my life difficult. Well, I didn't know better. But now I realize that as a Christian, it made me to grow. You know, it made me to grow as a woman and as a mother and a Christian girl. Because to me, I was like a girl when my parents were still alive. But when they passed on, now I had to take a role of being a woman and a mother and stand in my 2 feet, you know. And my relationship with God really started I actually started to rely on God more. You know, I started seeking His face. I think my relationship with Him rekindled, or I reconciled with Him in a more deeper and a closer way. And I think that is what made me to be strong, I guess, or to have that courage, you know, of continuing with my life. Because there were some other days, I won't lie, I felt like, you know what, this is not for us. You know, I felt like we could take something and drink something with my son and just sleep and just die. You know, but one day I attended a service, and then pastor was speaking about life in abundance, and that's when I thought, you know what, I can really get closer to God, and this will work out if I totally or completely put my trust in God. And that's when my relationship with God grew, I like to believe, and I like to think, and it grew. And I think what sustained me through all of that, it was God and His power. You know, He spoke with different people in my life. You know, I really felt like I wanted people to feel pity when they looked at me, you know, because really my situation was not good. But I would find people who would encourage me in the Lord and really would share the word of God, who would encourage me to actually get closer to God and get to know Him and His will for my life. And it sustained me. So as I conclude, I would just like to encourage everyone maybe who's facing similar situation or even worse situation than me, we must take courage in God. You know, we must fix our eyes on Him. You know, He is indeed the author and the perfect of our faith, and He's our sustainer. Even this day, you know, I cannot tell you how I survived most of the things, but I just seek God. So when you are going through things, just trust in the Lord. He is God after